Well, it's getting hot in here. So I took off all my clothes, but that wasn't the best thing to do. So we're going to take instead and we're going to put this in that. Oh, it's fixing to not be hot in there. All right. It's the 1967 Ford F-100. And we're going to put the vintage air kit in it. All right. So I'll start and stop this as I open boxes and put things down and check out what's in the boxes and everything. So, because I don't, just recording this with the phone, holding it in my hand. So, you know. All right. All right. Got the boxes opened up a little bit. So let's see what we got in here. Plenty of bubble wrap packaged up good. Something's already open. What's this guy? Well, let's see whatever that is. Ah, got some instructions and some fasteners. All right. I downloaded all the instruction manuals already and read through them. They looks like it's going to go together pretty easy. It's the kit that's designed for this truck with this engine, you know, this year model, specific for it. So should go together pretty good. Let's see what we got in this one. Everything's packaged up real nice, it looks like so far. Plenty of foam and bubble wrap. Some brackets. Box says handle with care. Ooh. Pretty. It's the vent system that's molded to fit right underneath the dash. And when you're done, it looks like it belongs there. So, all right. It's like more instruction kits. All right. So I'm going to finish opening these, see what we got, and get started. Maybe find some heavy metal on that YouTube channel over there. Woo! All right, we pretty much got it all unboxed. You know, each component or each section came with its own instruction pack, but I got the whole thing printed out anyway from the website. Good looking compressor. Got the condenser in black, so when you're looking through, it's not shiny through the grill. Looking all aftermarket like that shiny radiator is in that thing. So that'll hide that pretty good. Hose kit. Thing's got caps on it. This guy in there. Bottom pulley kind of mixed in with the dampener. This all comes as one piece on this. Got three grooves, so if you want to run power steering, you got the pulley for it. I'm not running power steering. More pieces and wiring harnesses and nuts and bolts. Good solid bracket to mount this thing. Then interior parts. New glove box well for when you get this thing under the dash. It takes up a little room where the glove box goes, so they give you a whole new insert for that. It's cut around it. The under dash vents, the tubing, some nice controls to replace the fits right in the dash and looks retro. Should look pretty good when it's all done. Got stickers on there, so you peel those off and it's shiny. One thing, here's the main unit. Just replaces the old heater that's in there, and it's a little bit bigger, so it's got the air conditioning combined in it. Everything was packaged really well, so you know, no damage in shipment so far that I could tell. Only thing, this box was already open, which always makes me nervous when you get an open box, but looks like it's there. It's got the O-ring still taped to it, and doesn't look like, looks like somebody just opened it up and looked at it. Probably put it back, but you know, shouldn't be a problem. And if it is, I'm sure Vintage Air will make it right. They're a reputable company, and that's one of the reasons I bought this kit. That, and it's, you can buy all this separately, but they sell it as a complete kit also, so you got everything you need to install. And looking through the instructions, it don't look like that bad of an install, but it's always a daunting task getting started. So first few pages is all disassembly. And I hate the disassembly part, because then I'm committed, because I can't drive it until I finish, because I'll have everything apart. But you know, it's gonna fit in here with the old 300, and should go pretty good. Bracket's gonna mount here for the compressor, and you can integrate the power steering right onto the same bracket if you had power steering, but I don't, and you know, probably won't ever, but maybe one day, you never know. I do plan on putting a different intake and exhaust, get the four barrel intake and the header, dual header exhaust. I have that Oppenheimer. No, I'll video that too when I install all that. Or Oppenhauser with the Holley four barrel and then the dual exhaust. So just putting that kit on adds 50 horsepower to this guy, so yeah, should be pretty fun. So start demoing the outside, and then we come around on the inside, and we take this guy out and start taking things apart in here. Have to find a different spot for my emergency flasher switch, but that's no biggie. Been waiting on this kit to come in to do several things at once. And one is peel all those stickers off of the interior that came with the truck, but they're kind of cool. It's just old 60s bands, 70s, yeah. Fun little stickers, little retro looking goofiness, but yeah, not bad. Yeah, it's gonna be fun. All right, so I'm gonna get started. Start taking things apart, and we'll see what happens. Because I can't wait to have air conditioning in this thing. It's only, you know, it's 5:30 or so in the afternoon, and it's still over 100 degrees right here. So air conditioning is going to be nice. And then when the Roadrunner is going back together, it'll get a vintage air kit in it also. It was an original AC car, so it should go together pretty easy. But I've got some of the original components, but I don't know what kind of shape they're in. Anyway, that's a whole nother video. All right. This is why your hot rod needs air condition in Texas. All right, step one complete. We got the disassembly. First thing was disconnect the battery, drain the radiator, take the heater hoses out. Then we moved on in. Took the old heater box out, glove compartment apart, had to take the radio out, all the controls for the old heater box, instrument panel, dash pad, you know, the ductwork, the little outside air, what do they call it, a fresh air inlet, or whatever, the little box right there for the vent. Got a lot of leaves and dirt daubers and cowboy hats and possums and everything else crawling in that. So blew it all out with the air hose, made a mess, and blew it out the other door. But disassembly's done. You can see how where's the last person putting this guy together? Fault with that dash pad a little bit. Look. Oh, my light fell behind the seat.
There we go. Still got their labels on the wiring harness. That's kind of cool. Just left all that on there, but not too bad. All right, next step. Let's see the old instruction book out here. So I got the swamp cooler. Show you what I'm working with. Got the swamp cooler here. Got a big fan in that corner, a couple of ceiling fans going. And it's about 9 o'clock or so. And we're still looking at almost 90 degrees and 62% humidity. Woo! Summer, summer, summertime. All right. So disassembly done, and we can start condenser assembly and installation. All right, so we're gonna start putting stuff together. It's gonna be fun. It's gonna be fun. We'll get a little air conditioning going on in this thing. See what happens. And I'll bring it back to you when I get to another good stopping point, or if I run into any trouble, I'll just keep on adding to this video and see where it takes us. Shop's kind of a mess. I could sure use an apprentice if anybody's interested. How to clean it up. All you gotta do is know how to push a broom and open a beer, and you're hired. Doesn't pay you anything though. All right. Of course, I got to the next step on the instructions, and it said see other instructions, so we had a little more disassembly to go. So we've got the grill and the headlights and everything removed, so we can start installing that condenser. And got the inside pretty well disassembled too. I think I already showed that, I don't remember. But got the wheels off, got it up on jack stands because I had to get underneath and take the bolts out from under here. Probably could have reached them around the wheels, but you know, whatever, gives me an opportunity to check out the brakes while I'm got it on the jack stands. And so when I got this apart, you know, I knew I had some on the core support. It's got some rust down in here. Could see that from the bottom, so I went ahead and got online on LMC Trucks and ordered a new core support. I think it's a few $100. Went ahead and ordered all new hardware for everything while I was at it. I was gonna get new fenders, but they got them back ordered right now, and I think I can repair that rust spot. But last time I looked, they were $50 cheaper and they had them in stock, and this time when I looked, they didn't have them in stock. They were on back order, and you know, the price had went up, but no biggie. It's not terrible. I think I can do a repair. I could probably just cut that out and replace the metal and probably be fine. But so next step on it, I'm at the core support, and since this is the 6-cylinder version, the opening isn't very big, and so the instructions say if you have the 6-cylinder version to trim it out to 27 5/8 inches, and to get the I guess to get the maximum cooling effect. If it had the V8 version, it would probably already be that big. And it says just trim the driver's side, and the reason for that is we're already up against the frame and everything with the radiator on this side, and so on this side we've got room to go. So we can trim that out and go around. But because I just ordered a new core support, because this one's rusted on the bottom, I think before I do that step, I'll wait and see what comes in, because I didn't even notice what size it said the opening was on the new one I ordered. And it didn't ask me if it was a 6 or 8-cylinder. Did ask if it was 4-wheel drive, which 4-wheel drive is a little bit different
on the radiator setup. They call it the super cooling system or something, and they have a little more standoff, and you know, just gets a little more airflow, I believe is I believe that's the difference, but I don't know that for sure. I'm just kind of guessing based on what the instructions were saying in this kit. So anyway, I'll just move on to something else, like doing the work on the inside instead, while I wait on the parts, while I wait on my new core support. That way I only gotta do this once, and may do the brakes. Brakes feel good. I think I'm just gonna inspect them and see what we got in there. At some point in the future, we'll go to a disc brake conversion kit. May even do just a whole new front end, do the Mustang front end type thing. But I don't know, that's down the road. I don't mind driving on drum brakes for now. It's not super fast yet, but once we get to that point, then we'll do those things. So I think I'll move inside and start working on the interior parts, and see where we go from there. But this, like I said, I hate getting started, because now I can't drive it till I put it back together. But that's all right, because I've got others to drive, and it's about time to head over to Waffle House, get some breakfast, and we'll come back and we'll work on the inside. You know who is coming, but you know. I think I'll drive one of the other trucks over there. All right, here's the parts I've been taking off, so I'm just storing them in the back. And that's the while we're out here, one day we get this Plymouth going. I think I'll drive the 56 to the Waffle House. All right, I'll be back. All right, welcome back to the garage, the shop, the man cave, whatever you call it. I like to call it the place where you spend 2 hours looking for the tool you had in your pocket 3 hours ago. So, working to put the dash pad back on. I got the defroster vents in, and that was the only reason to take the dash pad off, but man, what a job. The nuts and bolts that hold that sucker on all the way across. So I haven't got very far, because I just spent a couple hours looking for that wrench, and retraced all my steps for the day, and eventually found it in the back of the 56 Chevy with the battery and a couple other wrenches, where I changed the battery in that thing earlier today. But you know, the heat's getting to me. All right, so dark outside. Still pretty warm. Still working through this thing. And let's see what we're looking at. Still 90 degrees. All right, dash pad's back on. Kind of a pain in the butt, but you know, some of those things are hard to reach, but it's there. And I started working on the next step was getting the little grommet for the hoses to go through to get up to the front. And I thought I'd stop and film some of this, show you what I'm dealing with. So inside the fender here, just peeled off that piece of rubber to cover, because that's the hole that I'm gonna, where the hoses pass through here, a couple hoses pass through here and go up front for the air conditioning. This truck is it's got a couple of bad spots on the fender right here. And I believe it's because the previous owner was from Florida and he liked to drive on the beach. You know, and that's just horrible for a car. You know, and all that salt water in the sand, you get the sand all up on the thing. So right behind that rusty spot, behind this little, you know, this is a kind of a rubber seal or some kind of, I guess it's rubber. I'm not sure if that's original or not, but it's got a lot of rubber pins holding it in. But so I started just blowing dust out of it, and man, look at this. The amount of dirt and crap coming out of there is amazing. So gonna be doing a lot of cleanup under here. Get this thing up on the lift and undercoat the entire bottom of this thing and take care of any of those rusty spots. I'm eventually gonna patch that rust, change that fender, one of the two, and you know, get behind there and make sure there ain't nothing eating it up back there. I'm not going for perfection. It's got a couple spots on the door too. Not going for perfection with this guy. I'm going for daily driver, but I don't want it to sit here and rust while I'm driving it around, because it used to live on the beach. So we'll get all that cleaned up and taken care of. You know, I like driving on the beach too, but you gotta wash that stuff when you're done. But you know, that's where, you know, this rust came from, and the bottom side of it's pretty bad. So that's why I got a new one of those ordered, and I'm gonna wait and change that before I continue on the front end, before I put those coils for the air conditioning on up there, get all that changed out, be good to go. So yeah, that's where I'm at. So this kit is kind of it's a lot of work, but you know, it's kind of fun doing it, so it ain't too bad. If you got any kind of skills, or think you might have some skills, or you can follow instructions, and hell, if you can put a Lego set together, you can do this. So you know, step by step, just may take a while. I think once I do it once, I'll be able to do it a lot quicker. So you know, I can't wait to get that Roadrunner put together and get one of these kits in there. And I may get one of those smaller, cheaper kits and stick in the 56, because it's got you know, I don't know if they make a kit specific for it, but it's, you know, I don't think AC was an option for that thing originally. And so it's going to be an under dash little, you know, kind of thing, but I don't know, probably not, you know, wide open is like 45, 50 in that thing anyway, you know, so it's not a big deal, but definitely going to have AC in this Ford. This is going to be my daily driver truck. This is going to be the one that I drive around. My go-to trucks. But yeah, fun stuff. All right. Got cleaning to do. Keeping going. Good morning. All right, back at it. Not real sure where I left off, but we're gonna get back at it, and I'll just update where I'm at and what's going on. The piggy likes it. Goats are just making noise. It's so freaking hot out here. I put some sprinklers for the chickens and try and keep them cooled off, but not bad this morning. So yeah, tell them, boy. All right, so before I got to the step of modifying the radiator core support, I went ahead and bought a new core support. This one's got some rust in areas. I think I showed you that previously on the video. So I've got some holes cut in the fender, and got some holes cleaned up in the firewall. Getting ready for that part of it. So I'm going to go ahead and start installing that guy.
gonna yank the fenders off and everything because I gotta unbolt them anyway. So while I'm at it, I'm gonna go ahead and take those off and clean up everything I can around those. And inside, test fit the bracket. One of the next steps, so you can mark off the insulation where you got to cut out insulation and get that all put in. So next step, take that bracket in here, is take that bracket off, put the insulation back on the firewall, and make sure you don't cover where that bracket is going. You know, got inside here, got that guy fixed up. You know, that little pass-through hole, had to drill the attachment holes. And get there, got the insulation to put over that and get all that cleaned up. And so we're gonna start going back together. You know, just continue on, keep on trucking. Got some new headlights to go on this thing when it goes back together. It's a little surprise, a little custom touch. We'll get that fixed up and going in. And I think first step of today is going to be clean up the work area. This shop is a mess, and get that cleaned up so we got a little more room to work, got a little room to put things down and around. And I'll pick back up on the video as soon as I get to the next step. Hey, it's a little cooler today. It's only 85. Oh, wait a minute. Humidity's 85. Temperature and humidity's 85. Dang. So that's what happens when you drive your truck on the beach and you don't keep it cleaned up afterwards, is you get that kind of stuff going on. That fender can be repaired. Might be cost effective just to change the whole thing. Only a couple of $100 a fender. Easy to install. Just gotta paint it. If I cut that out and patch it, I gotta paint it anyway. So I'll probably just put new fenders. Yeah, same story on this side. All right, keeping going. All right, took a few more pieces off. Got the hood out of the way, especially once I took the core support off, because it holds up the inner fenders, which holds up this rail, which is what's hood's hooked to, so has a lot of weight on it. And it's easier to work without that hood on there in the way. But I waited till now to take it off because I didn't want to do it by myself and I had to get somebody to help me hold it up while I lift it over there and set it. So this is why I'm changing the core support. And so I got some cleaning up to do. I'm gonna put rust back on it once I got it off. So I'm gonna clean all this up and freshen all that up, get it looking nice, kill all that rust, and start putting this sucker back together. I think I'm got all the parts off that I need to get off. I don't think I need to take any more away, but while I got it this far apart, got plenty of access to clean all this mess up. So I may put the wheels back on it and roll it up on the lifts and get underneath of it. That way I can get
I can really get underneath and just start taking care of some of that bottom beach sand and stuff, make sure that's all cleaned out, them all the little holes and tight spots, and you know, just undercoat the thing just to make sure it don't get any more after I fix all these spots. But still working on this air condition project, so you know, it's that down the rabbit hole. Once you start one thing, it leads to another, it leads to another, and but it's going to be cool. It's going to be really cool once we're done. We're on the road, but yeah. So we got all this out of the way. Let's take a look. I pulled the starter off yesterday. I'm gonna go get the starter rebuilt because it gets heat soaked and drags. And we'll get a proper heat blanket on it when I put it back in. I don't know. There ain't many bolts left holding these inner fenders on, and nah, I'm not gonna take. I kind of want to take them off, just see what's behind them, and make sure that's all cleaned up. I may poke around in there, but I'm gonna start putting the air conditioning on it. A lot of it parts attached to that, and so. But I don't know. We'll see. May take them off anyway. Just clean them up and paint them. I don't know yet. But anyway. Keep you posted. All right, I went ahead and rolled it outside and did a little bit of cleaning with the pressure washer just to get started. I'm gonna go to the store and gonna run by some degreaser, really get in here and get it clean. Now, if you drive your older car and you don't want them to rust from the inside out, here, something to think about. Inside that panel there now is standing water because the drain is not draining. All of these bottom panels are supposed to have drains to prevent that. Water drains out, dries up, no rust. Well, either they get stopped up or full of dirt and mud and hold water and moisture and start rusting. Or someone does a lot of painting and undercoating and paints over the drain holes and seals everything up. Then nothing drains, holds water, rusts from the inside out. Especially right behind the wheel when you drive on the beach, pick up a lot of sand and salt water, just eats it alive. Not bad for one who, I know the guy drove on the beach because I dug sand out of it, and he told me he liked to drive to the beach in this thing when I bought it from him. But luckily he didn't have it a long time, or just eat the whole bottom off of this thing. So we can stop it, fix it, and get her fixed up right and make sure we got some drains. This side drains pretty good. Oh, so those are clear, so get all this cleaned up and make sure we got drain holes everywhere. And start fixing little rusty parts, and but we'll get her fixed up, get it cleaned, get all the salt air and sand out of the bottom, then get this thing back inside and put the air conditioning back in it, or in it to start with. The may stick it on the lift and finish doing the bottom while I got it started, get it cleaned up, just so it don't continue to rust. But I sure want that air conditioning in it so I can drive around. All right.